Hello all, welcome to IQPOP. Today I'll discuss on DBMS data modeling. So, what is data modeling? Logical design and structure of a database. And it also defines how data will be stored, accessed and updated in the database management system. Why do we need data modeling? If you cannot model, you can't comprehend. And if you can't comprehend, you can't control. And analysis and conceptualization is the first thing we need to do to understand what are the requirements we are going to have and how to maintain the database after implementation and all these things. Next, presentation, how we are going to present database data in front of the user. If we don't know the architecture of the database and how the data is going to be stored, where it is going to be stored, what form it is going to be stored, then it is not possible to present the thing properly. Next chance or less chance of project failure. So if you are having a good data model, if you have developed it, so there is less chance of being failure of your project. Standardization of the product. What software you are developing for what thing a database is going to be used. If you want standardization of that software, then you must go for data modeling. Now, there's different kind of data modeling based on our requirement. You choose one of them. Or sometimes multiple of them. Now data models, fundamentally we divide them in three parts or three groups. Object based data model, where data is going to be treated as object. Physical model, data is going to be stored physically. And record based model, data is treated as a record. Okay, so in object based model, we have entity relationship model and object oriented model. And in record based model, we have hierarchical model, network model and relational database model. Now here, entity relationship model. In entity relationship model, anything regarding what we are going to store that data in the database is going to be called as entity. And the data is going to be stored in form of table. So tables are going to represent entity, and what data we are going to be stored in the table, they are going to be called as attribute of the entity or property of the entity. So here, if department is a entity, so we want to store data about departments, then department is the entity. And what are the property or attributes are there for department? Their name, department ID, address, who is the head of the department. And another entity you can see on the screen, that is faculty. Faculty is having few attributes like faculty name, employee ID, date of birth, other number, address. And so it is about entity and their attributes. Now in this model, we represent some relationship between the entity. We define the relationship. So here, there is a relation between faculty to department. That is, faculties are employee of a department. So employee is the relationship here. So this is what entity relationship model. So object oriented model. So database as a collection of objects. So what is this? So this is something like we have a database which collects or stores, say, some components of software. Say we have a software which includes lots of media, code, image, voice, or say audio, video, too many things, right? XML file. So if some database is there which is going to store all these objects for the software, so we can call it as a object oriented model. Next is hierarchical model. So what happens hierarchical model? we store data in a hierarchy, so that who is, you know, parent node, they can get access, or they can have the data available with them of their child's data, right? But siblings are not having access to each other. So you can see university is a root of the hierarchy, and it is having three children, school one, school two, and administrative department. Now, school one is having students, faculties, courses. Courses may be again theory and lab. So data can be arranged in this order in the database, and if it is arranged like that, then it is going to be called as hierarchical model. Next is the network model. So it is a hierarchical model, but in hierarchical model you can see here it is a tree, but in case of a network model it is a graph. That means siblings may be connected, or there may be a cycle in the hierarchy. So here you can see, say few faculties are associated with some administrative department, then this administrative or administration department is having access to or have the data of faculty again. So here you can see this faculty database is going to, or faculty data is going to be in a subset of school as well as a subset of administration. So it is forming a cycle. So it is kind of graph. Okay. So if a situation is like this, then we call this as a network model. Next is a relational data model. So in relational data model, we store data about real life object as relation. And here relation is nothing but the table. So we store data in tables, and these tables are going to be called as relation. So here we can see this is a student table, registration number of student, name of the student, date of birth of the student is there in the table. So this is a student relation. This course relation, so course code, course name, credit of the course, all these things are there. So we can say this is course table, but we should call here course relation. Now the main thing in this relational data model is there is a third table you can see here, which is representing relation. That see here, registration number, it is keeping from the student table, course ID it is keeping from the course table or course relation, and it is giving the mark. So what is this relation representing? That registration number something in course code something get or got course or score this much marks. So from this table we can map that which student in which subject how much marks has been scored, right? So this is what relational model. Now numbers of times we heard about this term in database, schema. So what is schema? Schema describes the database precisely. So it doesn't matter in what data model you were. If you are describing your data model in some, you know, representation, and you are describing everything precisely, then it can be called as a schema. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share, and subscribe.